Hello, and welcome to Get Hooked on Webhooks with FME Server Automation Tools for Your Enterprise. My name is Carl von Stetten. I'm a GIS analyst with Central San, and I've been with Central San since about 2000, and I've been using FME since about 2002. Central San is a wastewater collection and treatment agency serving nearly 500,000 people in central Contra Costa County, which is part of the San Francisco Bay Area in Northern California. Our headquarters are located in Martinez. In our complex world, there is no single software application or enterprise system that can handle every business requirement. Multiple enterprise applications are the norm. These applications and systems frequently need seamless, real-time communication and integration to maximize efficiency. And FME Server Automations can make that easier. So I'm hoping that by the end of this presentation, I'll have answered these two questions for everyone. The first is, what are webhooks and how do they work? And the second is, how can webhooks be used in FME Server Automations? Now, this all came about for us at Central San because we had a couple of real-world problems to solve with our own enterprise systems. We use Cityworks Asset Management System, which is a GIS-centric asset management and work management system. And one situation we encountered was that we have CCTV inspection work orders that are created to inspect our pipes. And they're often assigned to one crew, but later reassigned to another crew. And we needed a way to let IT Pipes, another system, know that the inspector had changed. A second situation that came up was that for certain work order types, we needed to inject a custom comment into the work order. And that comment needed to contain a hyperlink to yet another application that allowed our field workers to access maintenance history, related documents and manuals, and spare parts availability for the asset that they were required to do work on. Now, this is not something that Cityworks can do out of the box without custom programming. So, our solution to both of those problems was to use FME Server Automation, and specifically webhook triggers that would respond to Cityworks events. So let's get into answering those questions that I brought up earlier. First of all, what is a webhook? Well, here's Wikipedia's definition. I'll give you a moment to read it, but it's probably going to be a bit hard to comprehend if you're not a programmer or web developer. So let's see if we can do that a little bit better. So in this context, we're talking about a webhook connecting two business systems. So we need business system A and B to be integrated. And so whenever an event on business system A happens, say creating or updating a work order, or maybe it's, we're working with ArcGIS Online and we're adding new features to a feature layer or creating new content, we want business system B to be notified so that it can do something, take some appropriate action. Maybe creating or updating corresponding data. So we need to send a message, right? That's what the webhook does. But how does it make the notification? It uses an HTTP request. Well, what's an HTTP request? Well, that's sort of the backbone of how the internet works, how browsers and servers talk to each other. When you open your favorite browser and you type google.com in the URL bar and hit enter, your browser makes an HTTP request to Google's server and says, I want your homepage, give it to me. And the server then sends that homepage content back to your browser, where you then get to see it. Now, maybe you're on another website and you're filling out a contact form, fill in your name and your email address, maybe your telephone number, and you hit submit. And when you hit that submit button, your browser then is making another HTTP request to a server somewhere. And not only is it saying, I want this page back to come back from the server, but it's sending all that data that you entered into the form, your name, your email address, your phone number. So in the cases of business integrations, server A is sending an HTTP request without a browser being involved. It just sends the message using internet protocols to business system B. But where is the request going? Well, business system B must have an application listening for messages on a standard web accessible port, an accessible URL. What if it doesn't? Well, we'll get into that in a moment. Here's some examples of systems that offer webhooks. You'll notice Cityworks is on there, and that's what I'll be talking about primarily. But most cloud application systems, most large enterprise systems, offer webhooks in some form. Now, webhooks aren't the end-all and be-all. They do have issues that have to be dealt with. So let's talk about a few of those. First of all, can the two business systems actually talk to each other directly? Are there firewalls in the way? Is one in the cloud and one on-premise? Because if you can't communicate directly, webhooks aren't really going to help you. Secondly, does business system B even listen for HTTP requests? If it doesn't, then again, webhooks may not help you here. Does business system B need to do maybe multiple things when it gets a request? Does it need to fire off two or three or four actions on its end to correspond to the message coming from business system A? Or maybe does business system B need more data from yet another system to combine with the webhook message before it can do something with it? And there are other issues as well. In the real world, these problems are often overcome by writing custom programs, which has short and long-term cost and schedule implications. So how can FME Server make this easier? Well, first of all, we start out by not sending the webhook message to business system B directly. Instead, we send it to an FME Server automation. And in that automation, we use a webhook trigger, I'll explain that in a minute, to listen for those messages. So now we have a guaranteed message listener. That automation can run an FME workspace, or two, or three, or even more. And those workspaces can do a number of different things. They could call APIs on business system B, as needed, using HTTP caller transformers, kind of like this. Or maybe business system B doesn't have any APIs. So maybe what FME will do is actually update or insert data directly into business system B's database tables directly. Or maybe they pull data in from even additional business systems, combine it all together with the webhook message, and then interact with business system B. Regardless, the end result is a no-code, let me emphasize that, no-code integration that you can maintain long-term using tools you are already familiar with. So, I'm going to do a quick demo. And in the interest of time, I've already pre-configured everything, but it only took me a few more minutes than explaining it will take to actually make it happen. So let me get in here. So here we have our FME server, and I'm going to go into the automations section of the server and manage automations. And I've got one already built here. So here's our automation. We start out with what's called a trigger. This is a webhook trigger. So all I did was go in here and set the trigger to be webhook trigger. And as soon as I save the workspace the first time, it created this URL. And that URL is what we're going to send messages to. Next, I inserted a log action. so that we can log the messages coming in and for testing and for debugging. And then I pass the message on directly to a workspace, and that workspace has some published parameters, the last one of which is has the label JSON data. This is where the message is actually going to be sent. So I just went in here and pointed it to use the message content coming from the webhook trigger. So that's that there. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and start this automation. So it's actually now running and waiting and listening for messages. All right, so now we're over here in Cityworks and I'm in the designer. And if I go into Action Manager, which is one of the features of Cityworks, I'm gonna start with a template. So I want a webhook template action. And I've got one down here I created for this demonstration. And this URL I copied and pasted directly from that automation in FME Server. So that's very easy to do. And then I filled in a header. I'm telling it what the content type of the message is. This is kind of important when you're sending data over the internet. I'm telling it that it's application/JSON. One of the other options is XML, but webhooks typically use JSON over XML. That's why I'm using JSON here. And the template is just a JSON object. And time doesn't permit me to get into a lot of detail of what that is, but in the resources at the end of the presentation is a link to some documentation on what JSON is and how it's structured. And basically this is just going to send what are called key value pairs in the message. So this is the key, and that will become an FME attribute when the workspace unpacks the message. And these are called tokens in Cityworks. And what happens is when this message is actually created, when a work order, when an event causes this template to be fired and the message to be generated, it will fill in the actual value for this token. So in this case, it'll fill in the work order SID value at runtime. Okay, so that's the template. The other piece that we have to configure is the event. So we're going to go back again, webhook, and I've got an FME webhook demo event created. And so this is basically configuring when that action template is going to be fired. So first of all, I've linked this to that template I created. So this is what it's going to fire. And I've linked it to just a particular type of work orders, this one template, work order template. And down under conditions, I've really just set this to always fire. You could have complex conditions built down here if you only want certain types of work orders or a certain circumstances if you want this to fire. But this is going to fire for every single new work order of this type. Okay, I'm going to hit the test button here. And what that's going to do is just send a blank or a test message to the webhook trigger. And we'll see that in just a second. So I'm going to hit test. And test. Okay. So I'm going to go back to FME Server and I look at the log file. You can see here's the message that it just received. That's the test message. It has a zero for the work order SID and everything else is blank because it's just the test message, but confirming that it did in fact send a message. Okay, let's do something a little more fun. Let's actually create a work order. So I'm in the create new work order page in Cityworks, and I'm going to send this to a specific work order I've created. That was that GIS webhook demonstration that I configured in the webhook. And that's really all I need to do. I don't need to add any more information. But really quickly, just notice the comments is blank, right? So there's no comments being created by me. If I hit create, Cityworks is doing its thing behind the scenes and it's created a work order. And look at that. There's my comment coming from my FME automation. I didn't create that myself, the automation did it. And just to confirm, go back and refresh the log. Here's the request from that actual work order. and it running the workspace with that message to actually create this comment for us. All right, so let's finish up the presentation real quickly here. A couple of tips and tricks. Just keep in mind that webhooks are very versatile. The example I just demonstrated isn't actually connecting two business systems. It's using a webhook to trigger FME to do something that Cityworks couldn't do on its own. So this is really Cityworks to FME back to Cityworks. But you can also be using webhooks that go Cityworks to FME to IT pipes or to ArcGIS or another system that you need to interact with. Another tip is when you're starting out and you're creating your automation, as I did here, just add a logger action. And then that way you can test that it's actually receiving messages. That helps you to make sure that your source application, in this case Cityworks, is actually sending the messages when you think it is. All right, to wrap up, we've seen that that FME Server Automation webhook triggers can facilitate powerful no-code integration solutions. Using the familiar FME workspace tools, publishing those to FME Server, and building them into an automation, you can accomplish almost anything. As promised, here are some resources that will help you to get started with webhooks in Cityworks, as well as how the automation triggers, all of the triggers, including webhooks, work in FME Server, and that handy JSON reference if you want to see how JSON messages are structured. And the next steps are really onto you now. So go out there and start building your own system integrations with FME Server Automations and make magic happen. Thank you for your time. If you'd like to reach out to me, if you have questions, feel free to send me an email at that address. I hope you enjoy the rest of the FME World Tour. Thank you.